We're at Montecito Cars and Coffee, normally Malibu, so I keep saying that. But we're hanging out with Dana, who has a 1925 Franklin that is now fully restored, or it's...
Correct.
Is it fully?
Fully.
There's nothing left.
I got it in Baton Rouge. That's where I got it. It came out of Baton Rouge.
Okay. It didn't come out of the swamp, though, because it kind of looked like it.
You're right.
It wasn't in good shape.
No. I've had about four of these in different states. I like very, very rare cars, and the rarer the better. So if I can find a one-off somewhere, that's what I'm looking for. So a guy named DeCosse, who was a designer for Locomobile, came over to Franklin in about 23. The Franklin dealers wanted something new. They had a horse collar in the front end, okay? And that was getting old. They wanted something new and exciting, and almost all cars were going to radiators. I mean, there were electric cars, there were steam cars, and there were gasoline cars. The public wanted a gasoline car more than anything. So they wanted to make it look like it had a radiator. So if you look at the front end, you'll see a fake radiator, okay? Only Franklin really perfected this, and it was actually copied by Porsche. I mean, some of the design features. This is the first commercially built boat tail ever. All cars of that era had to have a rumble seat. If you don't have a rumble seat, you're not cool, and you have to be cool. Anyway, this is a rumble seat roadster. They called it a runabout. So this is an 11A Franklin runabout.